One of Uganda's main opposition parties, the Forum for Democratic Change, has been in disarray over ongoing fights between top leadership. The FDC was degenerated into allegations of bribery and illicit money. In order to understand the depth of the matter, our journalist spoke to a political analyst, Professor Gerald Kagambirwe Kadeisha, who says that the party might be in its last days of glory.
Yeah, my take on this is that FDC has been having all these... All political parties have strifes, they have dissent, they have disagreements. But I think the mechanisms within FDC to resolve its own conflicts and to manage dissent have decimated. So it is falling apart. And I suspect it is partly because of the failure within the internal mechanisms to aggregate interests, which is the primary role of political parties. But at the same time, it has fallen prey to external forces and possibly the NRM to wipe it out.
The standoff arose from money which the FDC party president Patrick Amuria Tabor and the party secretary general Nandala Mafabi are said to have received from the NRM party. The party's deputy president for Buganda region, Elias Lukwago, and the party spokesperson Semujunganda were the first party leaders to question the money, which has been labeled as dirty money, during the parallel national consultative meeting they held at Nsambia Sharing Hall on 17th July 2023. Professor Gerald Kagambirwe Kadeisha elaborates on the chaos within the party.
Of course, at this point, it's very difficult for us to concretely establish whether the NRM is directly involved in tearing apart the FDC, but that it is happy about what is going on, I think is partly true. Why? One, NRM does not believe in multi-party politics. It was forced into it. President Yoweri Museveni is not a multi-party politician. He believes in an omnibus, a movement system, but he was coerced into accepting multi-party politics. NRM itself refused to be registered as a political party, but as a political organization. So to begin with, fundamentally, there is no belief in NRM to promote multi-party politics. So the failure of politics in the multi-party dispensation partly makes the argument NRM has been making before that we are not ready for political parties.
Since then, the fights intensified. The party leaders continued to wash their dirty linen in public as they attacked each other. The worst scenario was witnessed at the party headquarters when journalists were assaulted and some members were blocked from accessing the premises.
I think, in my view, it was a strategic misjudgment. When a fight is going on, the idea would be bringing people more to reconciliation than tearing them apart. So if there's fire going on, you don't flame the fire by putting in more wood. So what Nandala did, with or without merit, regardless of its merit, it will forever be perceived as a way of trying to get at Honorable Semujunganda, with whom they are disagreeing a lot in this drama and circus of FDC. Two, the Honorable Sibambi, who would have seen to prevail over this and maybe be among the third force, which is neither pro or against the protagonists, also, in my view, gullibly took over that assignment, which exposed the secret supporters of particular factions.
Other incidents include the FDC national chairperson Waswabiligwe jumping over the wall fence of the party headquarters in a dramatic manner. Besigye terming the elders' report unworthy, Amuriat locked in his office, Semujunganda being sacked from the position of party whip in parliament, and finally the elders' committee hitting back at Besigye.
I think that the biggest challenge that report came up with was, to begin with, its terms of reference. It never went to the bottom of the problem. The question is, what is creating the cracks in FDC? If it is the money, where did it come from? Who brought it and for what purpose? So the critical questions were never answered by the accused and the accusers. So I think that its failure to get to the bottom of the matter was the first challenge. The second challenge, in case they didn't want to go to the bottom of the matter publicly, they would have come up with a mechanism of engaging the different actors so that they don't reach a point where their outbursts are public. But I think that in their wisdom, they thought that they would take the safe road.
The FDC party president, Patrick Amuria Toboi, directed that 7 party members accused of hostility against the party appear before the party disciplinary committee. Professor Gerald goes on to say that even when the party survives the storm, it might not come back as strong as it was before.
I'm optimistic that the FDC will be in existence by 2026 and some people will run on the FDC ticket. But it will be a weak FDC, both at presidential and parliamentary level. I also see a possibility of another group leaving FDC, either joining NUP or coming up with another configuration. But I don't see it die immediately. Though, at the broader political sphere, I think that it's an experiment which later a number of political parties will pick lessons and see how to be resilient.
With the invisible hand still playing the tunes, the big question stands. Could this be the natural death of the once mighty FDC party? I name Babas Noah Mann, Urban TV, Kampala.